How is Arc helping customers reaching end of support for Windows and SQL Server? I'm here with Adam Burke, Director of Partner Development here at Microsoft. Adam, you talk to partners all the time. Tell us a bit about this experience.
Yeah, Arc is really providing, I think, new opportunities for our partners to help our customers as they really try and drive modernization conversations across our customer ecosystem, especially in SMB, I think is where we're really seeing these new opportunities. So if we look at, you know, kind of the different motions and opportunities for our partners when they encounter a customer that's in a end of support scenario, obviously modernize is always going to be where we believe the customers are going to get the best value. So helping them get cloud native technologies, that's always the first play. And if for some reason they can't modernize, but they're able to migrate to Azure, that's a great way to help them save money on purchasing ESUs, because ESUs, extended support updates, are actually free in Azure for 3 years after a product like Windows Server 2012 enters extended support. But for many customers, they're just not able to go to Azure today. One of the stories I often hear is, hey, we built this custom solution. The developer is no longer available. All of this is basically built for Windows Server 2012, and it doesn't seem to work on later versions. What do we do today? And so if that is the scenario you find a customer in, enabling them with ESUs through Azure Arc really helps, I think, in a couple of key ways. One, Arc is really going to be the most flexible for our customers. Two, I think from a cost saving standpoint, it really helps customers pay as they go. They do have to pay from October 10th in the case of Windows Server 2012 on. You pay from the time a product enters end of support. But once you upgrade and you no longer need the ESUs, you don't have to continue paying beyond that. So I think it lets customers discontinue that purchase once they've successfully kind of modernized and made that transition.
That's incredible. I'm sure there's a lot of benefits here for both the customers and the partners helping with this. So if I'm a partner and I'm hearing about this and I want to purchase ESUs for my customer, where should I go next? Where can I get started?
Yeah, so on our website, you know, here we're showing a screenshot of what it looks like to purchase ESUs in the Azure portal. So you would set up your customer with a CSP subscription, and you would be able to offer them ESUs through that subscription. All of these servers, though, actually live on premises. So that's one thing I think to help partners understand is you're not migrating anything to Azure. You're just making the resources available in Azure to interact with. We actually have a great demo within this playlist as well that I would encourage you to check out that actually walks you through it step by step to see how you can make that purchase really in Azure through Azure Arc on behalf of your customers. It's a pretty seamless and simple process, I think you'll find.
So watch the demo or go to dco.microsoft.com. Thank you, Adam.